Hey guys,
it's me again. I'm Kai at Moo Crew Creations, and I was asked to do a video of the shaker cups.
Hi.
So this is one I did. This is not sealed with epoxy. It just has glitter, contact solution. This is my daughter Miranda, one of my mini-moos. I use contact solution and acrylic tumbler that is double walled.
Yeah,
permanent vinyl. It didn't spill. That's right. I have done them. I did them first on these. I did find that the top seam does leak, so I did have to coat these with epoxy. But these were also easier to drill through. Yeah. So super easy. That's what we're gonna do today. You do need a 5-minute epoxy. Gorilla Glue has a great one. Something to mix it with and something you can throw away. Careful. Something you can mix it on so you can throw it away because there's no saving it. You need your glitter. I use a mix of chunky, fine. Sometimes I'm gonna have shapes today. I do put mica in the water or in the solution. Power drill. Mm. With not a tiny bit, like that's a good size. It's probably like a quarter inch. I use this to help put mica in. Sometimes I use it to shove glitter in, so metal stick. Just a metal stick. I honestly don't even know where this came from. I use a syringe. I started out with a paper funnel, but now I found my little tiny funnel, so we'll see what one works better. And then I use contact solution. I've done glycerin and I have done glycerin with water, and to me the glitter would clump and stick, so I use just straight contact solution and it works really good. For the Mickey Mouse tumblers, you can only get 2 cups out of this, but these acrylic ones from Amazon that come with a lid and they come with straws don't take that much. I don't know. They're about the same size, but I think the wall spacing is smaller. Can you back up, please, and sit down? Thank you. So what we're gonna do is let me adjust you down so you can see the work area.
My mommy said I could be edgy apple.
You are my helper today. So these ones are a little more durable, a little bit of a thicker plastic, which is great. Like I said, these don't tend to leak, so you're fine. My OCD has me drilling through the center point of the cup, and to me, that's where they form it, and it's probably gonna be the thinnest part of the plastic or acrylic. So I just put my drill here. Now the trick is you wanna put a little pressure, but you don't want a lot of pressure. If you put a lot of pressure, you're gonna crack. But you don't wanna do too much pressure because then you'll go straight into the bottom, the inside layer. So you can go slow. A little fast, so a little pressure. I do try to take some of the shavings off because I like to get a gauge of how deep the hole is. Again, you want a little bit of pressure. I'm just taking, you just see that it's got the hole, but it's almost all the way through, like the tip is already through. So now it's gonna be cleaning up the hole. Miranda, please sit up. Thank you. Yep, we're through the hole in the center, but we gotta get it out. Perfect. So it all the way went through. I have, barely any pressure, but enough pressure to get the drill into the plastic. And not enough to spider crack it. So I'm just taking my wooden spatula sticky thing and cleaning that up a little bit. Just because this one left a little bit. Okay, you know what? Let me dust this off. I'm just gonna... There we go. Get any of that acrylic out. So here's the fun part where we add the glitter. I tend to, I think about adding mica because I'm like, okay, well, I don't want the why not color the solution a little bit? I haven't figured out the right amount yet. But I do put like a good amount in because I haven't had enough. Like this one, you can't tell, but there's actually a pink sheen to it. Once you get the glitter swirling, you can really see it. So I figured why not? So I needed just to add more. And I just put it in, shake it around. So this is actually Ringo from Radioactive Glitter. It is a purple color shift. We're gonna make like a witch
hocus. It's my favorite color.
It is your favorite color. We are gonna make a hocus pocus Halloween shaker today. Uh-huh. We've done lemon, we've done Mickey Mouse and Minnie Mouse. So I thought, why not? I don't know if this is gonna work, you guys, but I'm thinking like, why not put some glow mica in there and see if we can get it to glow a little bit. Like even if it's just a little bit, how fun would that be? So we're just gonna push it all in. No, Mama, that's what it's supposed to do. It's okay. So I'm just gonna pour some in, and you can use your little strainer. It'd probably be smarter to use your strainer, but you know, I don't always make smart choices. Okay, so glitter time. Let's see if this hole, oh, it's just the right size. Not big enough to actually sink in the hole, but big enough. No, Mom's gonna hold it, okay? See, the nice thing about the paper is it props in there and kind of holds it, but it also can go all the way down and block the hole, and sometimes it falls over. But I kind of like this one. Maybe I might do a bigger drill bit and it could like wedge in it. Oh, done. Okay, so I do a mixture of chunky, fine. Sometimes I do shapes, so we're gonna try to put hats in. I just pour a bunch and I literally just filled it. And then I use my little pokey tool to help push it down. And you'll just see it goes in really good. Like, then I just shake it every once in a while. And that's kind of like the good thing. If you have a little funnel that can wedge in there, the whole shaking it to help get it out of right here so it's not just clogging. If you can shake it out of the way and it holds, then it actually goes in a lot faster. See, and it's already through. Like, I thought chunky glitter was gonna give me issues getting it in. And that's why I used the bigger drill bit hole, but it actually works out perfect and goes in pretty easy. And this is a chunky mix. So it's got a regular size chunk. It's got some fines.
Mama, I want to watch it. Go
look,
right here.
You're watching it right here. And I'm just helping get it through. Okay, so that is Glitter Designed by Two Custom Mix. It's the Hocus Pocus mix. So it's got purples, it's got a little green, a little orange. This is Glitter Glam's. Glitter Glam's All Hallows Eve. It's an orange and black chunky mix. Orange and black holographic.
It like pumpkin tea.
It's kind of like pumpkins. But I figure Halloween / Hocus Pocus, we gotta go with the whole color family. And you can put as much glitter in there as you want, you guys. We'll do a little more orange. Like, I don't honestly know how much is too much glitter, but I'm all for glitter. Okay, so let's put a little bit of, this is Glitter Glam Spellbound. It's a green and purple chunky mix. Back up. Miranda. Thank you. That's perfect. That way we get all the colors in there.
It's working.
I do just have a little paper, Mama, under my cup to catch any that I spill. When I first was doing this, I had glitter everywhere.
Mama, it's working.
I know. Isn't that exciting?
It works.
And then I do try to add some shapes. So with hers, she's got Mickey heads. So why not try putting some sorting hats in there? So this is my Glitter Addiction sorting hats. And they're a smaller shape to where they should fit in the hole. Hey, Miranda, can you grab that for Mama? To where it should fit. We'll find out. I'm still finding Mickey and Minnie heads everywhere. Oh, it's going in.
Yeah, it looks good.
It's right on the border of, back up. It's right on the border of almost too small. Like, I wish.
Hey.
I didn't want to do a giant hole so where I could put the caps in, but I was really thinking about it. You got them in? Thank you.
I got one.
You can have that one.
No.
For being a handy helper. Woo! So some of them are going in, some of them are flying back, but we are getting the majority. The majority are going in. It's just working them through that little funnel. Like, it's just working them through the funnel. You can have it, sweetheart.
Thank you, Mom.
You're welcome.
I got two. I got two.
Mommy's going to be covered in Halloween hats. And I honestly go until I get that funnel pretty empty. But we got a bunch in there, so that's pretty exciting.
Yeah, I think I'm on top.
And if you have any loose glitter on top, just use your finger and it goes right in that hole. So I have a good amount of glitter all the way around. So I was able to get just the cheapest contact solution, and it actually came in a box of two bottles, which is great. I couldn't get the lid off. It just kept spinning in circles. So I just took something sharp and poked a hole through it. And you, because it's a bigger hole, you can do one of two ways. You can literally just like squeeze, but you might leak.
Uh-oh.
And so because you have to have a like a bubble almost with air, I promise it goes down. Hey, can you go get Mommy a paper towel from the table?
Yay, thanks, Mommy.
Or actually, haha. Yeah, can you go get me a paper towel, please? Thank you.
Hey, Mom. We got the paper towel on the bed.
Okay, can you reach it, though? So I just hold it at an angle and squirt it in. And I do this for the majority of the cup. Okay, then can you get it off the table, please? Oh, I did forget one thing, but I'll grab it real fast. So I fill it, and you just see it going in.
Mama, I didn't move it back up.
So you can do a couple things. You can plug the hole and shake it so it mixes with the glitter, and that will give you less of an air bubble.
Hey,
can you go get me a paper towel, please?
Oh, yeah, get right with me.
Okay. So, but the thing is you're going to get some bubbles in there. So you'll want to, but now glitter is unsettled a little bit to where you can add more liquid. But when you have a bunch of bubbles, it's not going to want to go in. So another way you can do it is take your syringe, pop it in. Thanks, sweetheart. That's perfect. Pop it. Don't forget to turn it over. You're not going to get, and you just fill it up. The bubbles will need to settle. So that's the only hard part, but you can see like my fluid's a little colored, and it's cool because it actually has the color shift effect to it.
We got done with it.
So more, just pop it upside down. And this is honestly like how I feel it once it gets close to the top anyway. I'm gonna have to let my bubbles settle a little bit.
I thought you'd be held down. Get the red with me.
You're welcome, sweetheart.
You're not red with me, girl.
Yeah, I did.
You had to put that red in.
But that, look, we got the hats. Like, I love that. This is going to be fun now. We just got to hope that it glows in the dark. Okay, so I'm going to let these settle for a minute. Let me go grab the one other thing that I forgot.
I want to do something.
No, Mama.
I did do something.
I just want you to sit on. No, we're not going to check it yet. Let me grab it. Okay, so some of those bubbles settled a little bit, not so much, but a little bit. So we'll see. So let's see, finger on the hole.
Mama, whoa, I got whoa. Mama,
It's about 2/3 of the way filled.
Mama.
So go slow when you start shaking it. Don't go super fast like I did. But it's slowly popping, so go slow so you're not getting tons of bubbles, but mix it around so it will give you a little more room. Let the bubbles pop. You just pop them right there. So don't mix this too far ahead of time. And then one other thing I forgot is I tried it a few different ways. When I did my epoxy, the 5-minute epoxy, I put a glue dot on, like, just a heaping pile on, and it would sink, and you gotta let it thicken a little bit, and it would sink a little bit, and I would do it, and then I got this like mound on the bottom, and I was like, man,
Mama.
Yeah. So then she's got a sorting hat on every finger. That shows how much flew out, Mommy. So instead, what I did was, I don't want like just a little colored square showing, so I have permanent laminate by StarCraft. It's literally just clear for when I do car decals if they're printed vinyl. So I just take a small, can you stop please? Thank you, sweetheart. So let's try a little more.
Okay.
So it's mostly filled, but we still have a good, I'm just doing it a little slower, and that is actually popping a lot of the bubbles. So if you messed up like me, and then I just have a paper towel to make sure it's dry. Yeah, we're closing the gap. I'm just slowly rotating it, and it's actually breaking a lot of the bubbles up. How cool is that, you guys?
Mama, I got a book of hacker. Hey, you're making a little bit mess again.
I am making a mess, but Mommy's a messy crafter, huh?
Yeah.
So let's move the bubbles around again. And like, we're problem solving my problem.
Mama, what about the hand?
Yes, Miranda.
Back
ahead. Okay, so if you're fine with that much, then you can leave it like that. If you want some more, I'm going to try to put in as much as I can. Okay, so we put in as much as we want. Actually, I lied. I'm going to put in a little more because some of the bubbles just popped. Sorry, my husband called. So we had a slight little pause in the movie. Okay. Mama, back.
Okay, I thought I'd get in here.
Can you go get me one more paper towel?
Right.
Because I use, actually, All right, so I use a paper. I usually use wipes, but because you want it dry, then I use a paper towel. All right, so that's done. So now we are going to let that set for a sec. There's nothing really needs to be done. This is 5-minute epoxy. It comes with a resealable lid, so it's not like you're wasting the whole thing at once. They always just say try to have it tilted up so the air bubbles go to the top. So wiggle it off. And the hardest thing is pushing the plunger evenly at the same time, to be honest. So I always do more than I'm gonna need. And the other one is not coming out, so we're gonna move to a new spot. So it will set. There we go. And then pull the syringe back. Like I said, I mix more than I'm supposed to because I'd rather not run out and have to make a second batch. So they even have a little sliver on the side, a notch, so that you can't put the cap on backwards. And then I just am mixing on a piece of foil. Just like epoxy you do, or the epoxy we use on cups, you want to make sure it's mixed really well.
Yep, that body we have, got your hands really good.
That's right, we're wearing gloves. It does smell.
Not me.
Yeah, that's why you're not, you don't touch epoxy, huh?
I don't go on.
So, I scrape it off, that's it. But you want to let it thicken. So what I do while I'm waiting is I just cut a little square that will go over my hole and completely cover the hole and go over more. So make sure the top is completely dry. If you do want to wipe it down with like acetone or I wouldn't do acetone, but rubbing alcohol, just to make sure that it's really going to stick, you can. But I just cover that hole and rub it really good. And this is permanent laminate. So I rub it really good. So now we are gonna let this set a little longer. I mean, Mama, it's pretty runny.
Mommy,
it's not a, because I used it for funnel. It's not a mix till clear. So I just mix it for a couple of minutes. It will start to thicken. Here's this. And because I have the hole plugged, you don't have to wait it for it to thicken too much. But what I do is I'm going to fill that entire circle just so it's kind of flush. Can you please turn the light on? No. It's okay. It's gonna take a while, Mama. So I just scrape it off. And I'm just going to let it fall. And then I'm going to use the other half of my wooden stick to just get it off my stick and get it that way we get to use it all. So I even could have made more. So then I'm just going to spread it out again. I cover that complete circle, so I am completely covering that piece of laminate. And then I am one with my OCD. I usually cut a cute little piece of vinyl and cover it because I don't want them to see it. But because, like, I did that for the Mickey Mouse because it just looked like a mess.
I'm not seeing it.
But it's actually completely, you can see it at the angle, that it is going to be completely flat on the bottom. So I just spread it out carefully. Don't get it too close to your face,
Mama,
to coat it. And that way you know that that laminated piece is completely covered. There's no, it shouldn't leak at all. I haven't had any issues yet, knock on wood. So we just let that dry for 5 minutes. I'm just going to pick up my mess a little bit. We let that dry for 5 to 10 minutes, and then it's fully functional, and then you can put more decals on the side.
Mama, it's
and that's it. And then you'll have, see, this is this one. So this one, it's fully dry, it's smooth, it's hard, but it actually is completely flat. So you can see that and where I drilled the hole. So this is all contact solution. I just wish I had like lemon shaped glitter. That would make it really cute. Boom. And then we need watermelon seed glitter. So it's really good, but it flows really good. And then, like I said, if you're drinking and you just want to show it off, just swirl it a little bit, like you're mixing iced coffee, and it kicks it up. But this one actually has a light yellow mica. Like I said, I'm still figuring out the amount of mica to put in it, but you can see a little bit of the purple color shift with this one, and it's really cool. So I'm not turning it over. Miranda, go inside. I'm not turning it over because that's not fully set yet. But yeah, you can see my purple mica in there. And it's also a color shift. Ooh, look, there's a sorting hat. I think it's cool with the little floating hats. And then I'll try to see if the glow-in-the-dark mica or glow powder, if it will glow in the dark. And if so, then I will take a picture. So that's it. That is all you have to do a shaker tumbler. Like I said, we're just gonna let that dry for about 5 to 10 minutes. When it is setting, it does get really sticky, so try not to touch it. But it looks great. Candy, and that's what I like about doing it in the center, is people are like, oh look, I wonder how they did it, because that's just the center where the cup is made, but really, that's where we filled it. So it blends in, it's more inconspicuous. That's cool. One of my new favorite styles of cups. And yeah, you have the color shift from the mica. But it's not super dramatic, but it's almost like a little potion. So let me know if you guys have any questions. I will post the links. I will list all the glitters I use. All the supplies I use too. Let me know if you guys have any questions. And I'll also add photos somehow if it does glow in the dark. Again, I'm Kai at Moo Crew Creations, and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Have a good day.